nuance was that we were already together as a band and had been for quite a while. And we're already known as basically the best band.
One shopping at this vintage store. I found this. And I also found a track I'll show you. Let me grab that. This is cool. Mickey's the Mean Green. It's going to be perfect for today because... I'm listening to a radio program right now. They're interviewing two guys that used to work for the Time. Producers, music. Found this on a track. Here, Nelson Ringo Starr. Son of Dracula soundtrack. $2. Still works. But I just noticed it doesn't have a felt thing, so I have to add a felt from one of the old other 8-tracks I had. We better hurry up. Mickey's fine malt liquor. Well, just getting the day going. Slept in. It's Labor Day weekend. And they've been giving her as much as you can give her. But every once in a while, you gotta just go get a 40 of Mickey's. Whatever kind of the malt liquor you can find, and just give her. Just be good to me. These guys used to work for the SOS band, I guess. That's pretty cool.
Do the two of you know when you were playing in rival bands and then when you were in the Time together that the two of you were just going to be bound at the hip forever? Was there a point when you figured that out?
I don't think it was, well, nothing specific, I think. But we, even in rival bands, I used to go and list Jimmy to play on my sessions when we took flight time in the studio. I would always get him to come and play keyboards on whatever we were trying to produce. And so we always worked together. Yeah. And
I love that.
Yeah. It was never any animosity and rivalry that way. It's just that when you get on the stage, then, well, somebody's got to go down. This is just the way that is. But as musicians, no, it was total respect. And, you know, I never knew that we were going to get together and be partners. And that all happened kind of just as a result of things happening in a negative way with the Time sometimes. And, you know, at a point, you know, we had an argument. They called a big meeting. And, well, we had a disagreement. We weren't even calling it an argument. Where we weren't being handled like we thought we should be. And so in the meeting, Prince asked us, you know, what we're going to do. I said, well, I'm going to do what I got to do, Prince. He said, is that a threat? I said, no, that's a promise. And so we went outside that room at that particular day, and I said, I'm going to L.A. at the end of the tour. Who's coming? And Jam said, I'll come. And everybody else said they were going to go home and buy a VCR. And that's why we're partners to this day, because we chose to be together and work together and, you know, take whatever would come. You know, we ate a piece of chicken and a strawberry soda and a biscuit.
When you think about it.
On in. And
maybe it's not so much for
we'll finish up with Jimmy Jam and Terry Lewis in just a minute.
Anyone else, but there's a
dive deep into the
certain class, group of people.
On that record.
Which accumulation of whatnots.
On Waypoint Don't Tell Me, we invite accomplished people on our show to answer the truly difficult
can end up being sort of a treasure chest gold mine full of pirates' booty. Catch my drift. There's no jive.
Support for WPR comes from My Choice Wisconsin, committed to the well-being of elderly and disabled adults, providing Medicaid and Medicare programs promoting independence, diversity, and self-advocacy. MyChoiceWI.org.
So my goal
WPR
for today.
In Wisconsin and around the world, you hear many perspectives and civil conversation every day.
Is to reach the goal. Yesterday I reached the goals. And then, as it turned out, it did start raining unexpectedly.
Hi, I'm Valerie Long.
But goals had been met, so today, there's no forecast of rain. Just wind, maybe some passing clouds. Cool. So that's good. Cooler weather prevails.
UNICEFUSA.org/endthepandemic. And the Kresge Foundation, expanding opportunities in America's cities. Grant making and social investing. More at Kresge.org. This is NPR.
But I'll be working on the two-story tiny house. Yesterday, I got the gable ends, or the gable end on the south side of the house, sheeted, Tyvek, taped off, and then I began doing the gable eave fascia. Which is a green LP
album with their name on the cover.
Product.
It's worth the wait. Let's get back into our conversation. Do the two of you do different?
So what I'm gonna do
on records is one.
Let's get that south side gable eave soffits.
Always the one picking up the bass guitar.
I mean fascia.
On the keys,
cut
is like having an extra bass player.
Attached.
So, a lot of times,
and then
I don't play bass at all.
I could do some soffit, the bird boxes,
my style.
And up the eaves on the rake.
Yes.
I still have to put the screen on the soffits.
So,
that's my goal.
So, Jam plays a lot of keyboard bass a lot of times. Or we had Big Jim Wright, who's
if I can accomplish that, which I should be able to, then I'm going to start sheathing the roof. Which will be a
I do produce a lot of the
shit.
Jam does a lot of the drum programming, or most of the drum programming now, and pretty much all the keyboards. He, at one time he made me play, and I always thought that was really senseless for me to try to play.
Which would be great because then it'll be dried in. Place won't be getting more and more. Place won't be getting any more rain.
I puzzle up on some stuff, and you know, I did some good work sometimes. Making keyboard parts, right?
I've got 9 windows to put in.
Sit back down and get my place easy.
Just sitting there waiting.
I think that's part of the key, too, by the way, is that we always say we have no slack, and we pick up each other's slack. And so there can be times where, you know, maybe I'll work on a song for a little bit, I can't really figure anything out, and I just throw it on a hard drive or something. And then, you know, years later, Terry will find it, and all of a sudden, there'll be like this song. And he'll play it, and I'll go, wait, where'd you find that? He says, oh, it was on your hard drive. I'm like, oh my God, I couldn't imagine it was going to sound like that. So we do a lot of that type of thing. But the thing I always say about Terry, what makes him such a great is.
I'm never going to make the 10-minute mark, so I'm talking.
He can say in a sentence.
So I got
his efficiency in writing is amazing. We were doing this, one of the songs I always give as an example. That's when we were doing Living in the World, they didn't make with Janet, and what turned out to be that. And we had seen the school shooting that had happened, and we wanted to write a song about it. And Terry wasn't there. He'd gone over, we were putting together a new studio in Minneapolis at that time. So, you know, we're having a conversation with Janet about it, and then Terry walks in with wallpaper samples in one hand and carpet
samples of the other hand, and he goes, well, which one of these do you like for the studio? I was like, Terry, no. Here's what we need. We got this song, and, you know, these kids got shot, and it's the adult's fault, and, you know, it's not these kids' fault, and blah, blah, blah. And we go through this long explanation, and Terry just looks at us and says, living in a world they didn't make.
YouTube will probably say this video is too long. Son of a. It's gonna feel like my little buzz kick in hardcore. It's a hardcore feeling. It's a wild ride of euphoria.
There's a million different ways to say I love you, and Terry will figure out a unique way of saying it when you go, oh, I haven't heard it like that before. And there's something that's so magic about that. I'm glad I get to sit every day and watch that happen as he creates that. I absolutely love that.
It's Bullseye. I'm Jesse Thorne. My guests are the songwriting duo Jimmy Jam and Terry Rice. I have a friend who is king nerd of the Minneapolis sound, just one of the greatest nerds of every tributary of that river, not least of which is your work. And he heard I was doing this interview, and he sent me this stem that I wanted to play. So
I better hurry up and get out of here. It's already. I'll have a chance if it's under 12 minutes.
I want to a little bit of a hit that you guys made.
Won't like a. Jack